feel like every family has their traditional pot roast recipe. I know my mom has hers, Chip's mom has hers. Like, it just feels like a really great staple. This is a 5-pound chuck roast. To start, I want to sear the meat. I'm gonna heat this Dutch oven on about medium high heat. I want that nice and hot. Since I'm gonna be searing the meat at a higher temperature, I'm going to kind of cover this with a canola oil. It has a higher smoke point than something like olive oil. And I'm gonna use about 3 tablespoons. I wanna get it nice and coated all the way around. I'm gonna go wash my hands real quick, and we're gonna do some salt and pepper. You wanna do about 1 tablespoon of pepper. I'm gonna do about 1 tablespoon of salt, and I'm just gonna start with the top, and then when I flip it over in the pan, I'm gonna do the seasoning on the other side. Okay, so I'm gonna take this over to the range, and we're gonna throw this in the Dutch oven. I'm gonna start with the seasoned side down. So what the sear does is it's just caramelizing all those natural sugars, so it really locks in the flavor. Wash my hands. Now I'm going to start on the veggies. I love to use the traditional vegetables like carrots and potatoes, onions and garlic. You can do about 3 to 4 russet potatoes. I've got a good chunk of these things that I forgot what their names are. Carrots, guys, this is a carrot. I am gonna quarter these potatoes. I'm gonna check the sear. So when the sizzling slows down, you know it's time to flip it over. I'm gonna go ahead and get this other side nice and seasoned. So with the parrots. Y'all, I'm not joking, and I'm sorry if you're worried. You should be. Carrots. Anyways, okay, salt. So with this mass of meat, it can take a lot of seasoning, so I'm never nervous that I'm overdoing it, but it's just simple, it's salt and pepper. I'm gonna use about 8 carrots and kind of rough chop them. I didn't peel the skin, but I went ahead and scrubbed them really good. The sear sounds great. It's telling me it's almost ready to flip it over. This actually feels like 10 pounds, but it's 5. Okay, so I wanna show you kind of what you're looking for. So I'm kind of a texture person, and the sear helps add to that texture to make it nice and crispy. Starting to smell like Sunday, guys. I'm gonna take a whole onion. I'm just gonna cut this in half. With the garlic, I'm just going to smash 2 garlic cloves. So it'll release all the oils. And that's it. Very simple. It's important to make sure that every side gets seared as well. One more side. What I'm gonna do next is deglaze this pot. Now, if you can see here all these little bits and pieces, this is fond, or the flavor. I'm gonna go ahead and add in 2 cups of beef broth. If I don't do that, the fond is gonna burn. So I wanna get all this stuff, that liquid's gonna lift it up. Okay, so now I'm gonna add 1/4 cup of the Worcestershire sauce. This is kind of like a one pot wonder. The veggies, throw my garlic cloves in there. This is where it's decorating. You're decorating your chuck roast. I'm gonna use just 2 sprigs of thyme. So here's my art project for today. And now I'm just gonna put the lid on this, stick it in the oven at 300 for 4 hours. Wow, that was heavy. So while that is cooking, I'm gonna start on the apple pie. I'm gonna get started on my apple pie crust. The key with the crust is it needs to chill in the refrigerator for at least 1 hour. So this is something you can do ahead of time. I'm gonna use 1 1/4 cup all-purpose flour. I'm gonna add 1 teaspoon of salt, stir that, and it's a stick of chilled butter in these nice 1/2-inch cubes. And I'm just gonna cut the butter so they're about pea size. You want them to be tiny. I'm gonna make a well, and I've got 1/4 cup of very cold water. This water is going to activate the gluten. So the key with this is you don't overwork this dough. I've got to get on my tiptoes. As it sits, it hydrates the dough. I go ahead and just grab this, put this on the plastic. Once it's done chilling in the fridge, I can just roll it right into a larger circle, stick it into the pie pan. So I'm gonna put this in the fridge, and now I'm gonna get started on the bread. I'm gonna be making a braided loaf today. The presentation is beautiful, but it's also pretty simple. First, I'm going to activate the yeast. I've got 3/4 cups water, 1 pack of active dry yeast, about 1/4 ounce. I'm gonna add 1 teaspoon of sugar to this. The sugar feeds the yeast. And I'm gonna stir this. Okay, so I'm gonna let this stand until it's foamy. It takes about 5 minutes. So I'm gonna dump all my dry ingredients into the mixer. This is 3.5 cups of all-purpose flour, 2 teaspoons of sugar, and then 1 teaspoon of salt. I'm just gonna mix this for just a couple seconds on low. So I'm gonna go ahead and put the yeast in here. 2 eggs, 3 tablespoons of canola oil. This is a traditional egg bread, also known as challah. And I'm gonna go ahead and put this on medium. I'm gonna let this go for about 5 minutes. Oh, it's ready. You can see this is pulling away from the bowl. It's ready to go. Oh, this is my favorite part of this job. Just give me a second. I love the smell of dough. You just wanna make sure so it's not sticking to the bowl, that you oil the bowl well. So I'm just gonna set it here, put a cloth over the bowl and put it in a nice warm spot and let this set for about 1 hour. And now we are gonna get started on the pie filling. And this is when things start really smelling delicious. I'm gonna start by melting a stick of butter. So this takes about 2 to 3 minutes. I'm gonna dump 1/4 cup of white sugar, 1/2 cup of brown sugar, 2 tablespoons of cornstarch. I'm gonna actually add this into the sugar blend. If I were to put it directly in there, it'll get kind of lumpy. So I'm just gonna make sure that this is nice and blended in here. And then 1/2 teaspoon of nutmeg and 1/2 teaspoon of cinnamon. Now it's starting to really smell like apple pie. Okay, so this is nice and smooth. I'm gonna let it sit and cool. I'm gonna get the apples ready, and then we're gonna fill the pie. I have 3 large Honeycrisp apples that I've already peeled, and to make it a little quicker, I've got this right here. And this is called efficiency. This is also called muscle. Oh gosh. My wrist hurts. It's just part of getting old, folks. Drake? Hey, Drake. Can you come down real quick? Call in the muscle. Come over here. Because normally, you know, I just slice them, but it takes me a while, so I thought this would be fun, but I can't do it. These are blades, so just be careful. Easy. Push down. See? I'm gonna just move these over here. All you need to do is center that and push down. Okay, Drake, use your core. Bend with your knees. Beautiful. You want a piece of apple? Take one out for you and Ella, because I won't need this many.
Take these two.
Take those two. Okay. Thank you, Drake, for being on standby.
You're welcome.
Are you hungry yet?
Yes.
Okay. Give me another 4 hours and that pot roast will be ready. Thanks, Drakey. So now I'm just gonna cut these in half. If you don't have one of those handy dandy muscle machines, you just slice thin slices of apples. But when you see a teenage boy struggle with it, you don't feel that bad, you know what I mean? I'm gonna tell you something that he may be embarrassed about. I can still beat him in arm wrestling.
That's not cool.
Drake, is it okay if I tell him I can beat you in arm wrestling?
Well, you already told him, so it's...
Oh, you heard? Drake, when we arm wrestle, are you still just being sweet because you feel sorry for me? Or can I really beat you?
I don't know. We haven't done it in a while. But I said we don't do it on camera.
Drakey, you want more apples?
No, I was just wondering if they were supposed to take the mic off.
Oh.
We can take it off, yeah.
The pot roast smells really good. Peek inside. Whoa. Look how pretty that is. Now for the fun part, y'all. Okay, I'm gonna start shredding the meat. That smells delicious. Okay. So tender. Kind of shred it like that, and it just falls apart. Mm, it's so tasty. I'm gonna set this down. It's Sunday. Everyone is getting ready for a busy week, and then for dinner, you've got this delicious pot roast. And then I'm gonna just top it off with these vegetables. I can't wait. I'm gonna add a little bit of this sauce. Look how pretty that is. And I'm gonna garnish it with some shaved Parmesan. You don't have to do the Parm. I actually love just a little bit. And we're done. Sunday pot roast. Okay, I'm gonna have one bite. Because that bread, I can smell it, and I am here for the carbs. Mmm, that is so tender. So here I've got a traditional kind of farmhouse salad with romaine lettuce, some radish, tomatoes, and homemade croutons. But the real star of the show is the buttermilk ranch dressing. Okay, and the bread is ready to go, so I'm gonna go ahead and pull that out. Okay, so while that's cooling, I'm gonna grab the pie. I'm gonna just top it off with a little bit of powdered sugar. Just dust it. Cut a slice of the pie while the bread is cooling. And I like to eat apple pie with vanilla ice cream. Whoa. Okay, I'm gonna just go for it. This is hard because I kinda wanna finish with dessert, but in my world, bread is dessert, so where's that butter? Whoa, look at that. Okay, I'm gonna just do a little bit of butter on this. Yum. This is what keeps me going, that middle part. I could eat that whole loaf all by myself. Well, last but not least, the good old classic apple pie. Cool. Hmm, that's really good. I'm trying to decide, should I eat all of this or eat half of that? So there you have it, the Gaines family Sunday pot roast. So good. Their buttermilk ranch dressing with a tiny bit of side salad. This delicious braided loaf and apple pie. You should try it this Sunday. Or next Sunday. But today my kids are gonna eat it on Monday. Drake and Ella, y'all come eat. Time to finish my pie.